Hello, my name is Stacy here, and today I would like to talk to you about what's new with our Git tooling in Visual Studio 2022. The first new feature I am excited about is multi-repo support. Visual Studio 2022 better supports cross-team collaboration by enabling you to seamlessly work in a solution with projects hosted on different Git repositories. You no longer need to switch between repositories or use different instances of Visual Studio. To get started, just make sure that the feature flag under Tools Options is enabled for multi-repo support. Once you do that, you can start by loading your solution, and Visual Studio will load the solution and activate all of your repos. You can also go to Solution Explorer and see that both of your solutions are there, and the status bar is indicating that both repositories are active. You can also get started by adding projects to your solution. And so as long as your projects are under source control, your Visual Studio will detect them. You can also click on the feature branch on the status bar, which would open the Git repository window. As you can see, both of my repositories are showing there, where I can browse and see my commits. And now to demonstrate how multi-repo works in Visual Studio, let's add a new method on our math library and then consume that method in our multi-repo calculator project. So as you can see, I am under the math library. I have the simplemath.cs document open, and I have just pasted the multiply method. Now let's go to the program.cs. If we go to the Git changes window, we'll be able to see that the changes we made are shown for both of the repositories. We can also filter and focus on a single repository using the repository dropdown, or choose to view both repositories and be able to commit our changes across these two repos with a single step. We can see the confirmation confirming that we have been able to commit across the two repositories. If we click on the outgoing incoming link, you'll be able to see our commit in the outgoing section for both repositories here. The Git repository window also supports network operations, so I can click on push to push my changes that I have just committed, and I get the confirmation. The Git repository window also supports creating new branches and even checking out a branch, which is becoming quicker as we have been improving the performance of Visual Studio. I can also focus on a single repository and push my changes through the Git changes window on the side. The second feature I'd like to demonstrate is about how easy it is to create Git repositories in Visual Studio 2022 and add your code to GitHub and or Azure DevOps. For those of you who haven't been using Git, let me just say that tracking your progress with Git is very helpful, even if you are the only developer in your organization and don't need to collaborate with a large team. Okay, as we can see here, Visual Studio is providing me with an option to add to source control in the status bar, indicating that this new project I'm on is not tracked by source control. If we go to the Git changes window, I also get an option to create a Git repository there. And for those who are new to Git, I highly recommend that you view our documentation. Now let's get started by creating our Git repository by clicking the Create Git Repository button. As we can see, Visual Studio pre-populates our Create Git Repository dialog, and the only thing we need to worry about is provide an optional description and then create and push to GitHub. It is important to note here that by default, the repository you are going to be creating is going to be private, which means that you are the only one who is going to be able to view your code. if you would like to create a Git repository on Azure DevOps instead, just use the Azure DevOps option on the side, which will also pre-populate the form for you. The only thing you'll need to adjust is the project that you would like to create a new repository to, and then create and push. As we can see now, Visual Studio is working on creating and pushing our code to Azure DevOps. And once that is done, I get a confirmation that it has been successfully created and pushed. I hope you found this talk useful. Feel free to view other talks about Visual Studio 2022. Thank you, and have a wonderful day.